Manchester United make their second bid for Rasmus Højlund, an improved bid confirmed by Fabrizio Romano, and it's not been rejected yet. Could this bid be accepted? And there is a feeling that Højlund's Man United, here we go, is expected in the next 24 hours. So make sure you subscribe, because I will do a video when that is official. But Amrabat to United is moving very quickly as well, because Thread has agreed terms to join Galatasaray. However, Galatasaray are pulling in pathetic bids, so could be on the way to Lazio to put in a bid. Donny could be off to Real Sociedad. West Ham want McTominay. West Ham have also bid for Maguire, which was rejected. And we've got a takeover update, which will all be discussed in today's video. Lots of news to get through, and we're going to get right into it, starting with the Rasmus Højlund news. It was said by Sky Sports, an agreement between Atalanta and Manchester United for striker Rasmus Højlund is now edging closer. And let's be honest, that's not really news. We know it's edging close. We know it's very close. United put in one bid that's rejected. They've now put in another bid. And if that is rejected, they're going to put in a third bid. And there's basically lots of reliable sources saying that United are going to get this deal essentially wrapped up at the weekend, so Højlund could come for his medical on Monday. We know that Rasmus Højlund has rejected PSG for Manchester United. Fabrizio Romano said on this breaking, Manchester United have an improved bid to Atalanta for Rasmus Højlund today. It will be more than a €60 million package. United want to close the deal as soon as possible. So Romano is saying it's more than a €60 million package. Atalanta want at least €65 million. Potentially, if Man United maybe do €60 million with €5 million in add-ons, it will be accepted. Alfredo Padula, who's been a fantastic journalist, Italian media is the one to listen to right now. British media are saying apparently we have to pay €50 million for Amrabat and €85 million for Rasmus Højlund, when in fact we know from Italian media, Romano, Padula, even Di Marzio, that it's actually €65 to €70 million for Højlund, which is like £55 to £60 million. Anana, Italian media was right with the price tag, and even though Italian media put out a lot of reports, like Kim and Jay and Amrabat saying it's done when it's not done, the reliable Italian journalists like Padula and Romano have said, look, Amrabat is €25 to €30 million, Højlund is €65 to €70 million, and Anana was £45 million. British media seem to be well off the case. It was said by Padula, Manchester United made a bid of £53.1 million plus £4.2 million in add-ons, taking it to about £58 to £60 million. Atalanta are asking for £58 to £60 million. The add-ons will make the difference. So essentially, Man United put an upfront bid of £53.1 million. And the add-ons is £4.2 million, which does take it to £57.3 million. Atalanta want £58 to £60 million. Man United just basically need to put another £1 million in add-ons, and that bid could be accepted. In fact, the way Padula's talking, this bid that United have put in late tonight, or it'll be the morning by the time this video is out, late last night, is it could be accepted. So we could get here we go early morning. I think they might have to negotiate it out and maybe have to add a bit more in add-ons, but I do think we're going to get Højlund, here we go, in the next 24 hours. It was also said Justin, Manchester United are close to completing Rasmus Højlund deal. Both parties are very confident to seal the deal. The contract is 5 years plus one, and the fee could be around €65 million plus €10 million in bonuses. So we know he's agreed a contract. We know that it's very close. We know the second bid's going in, and we know they're close to agreeing the fee. And the Rasmus Højlund stories is getting a bit boring. We've just got to wait for our here we go. And then when we get here we go, I'm going to talk about why Rasmus Højlund will be an incredible signing, how we'll improve United. I might do a video on like bits of Rasmus Højlund actually talking about United and talking about being a United fan as well, because I always think a bit of context to the player, his career is exciting. But Amrabat news. It was said, if a deal for Fred can be struck, it's understood Manchester United are ready to move quickly on a replacement. Amrabat's the primary targets, with talks with Florentina continue in the background. Sky Sports have confirmed, yes, United have had talks with Florentina. Ornstein, Romano have confirmed we've had talks with Florentina for Amrabat. We know United are interested in Amrabat. We know he's on the list, but we know the focus is Højlund, sales, then Amrabat. Italian media trying to make out Amrabat is done. It is not done. Personal terms might be agreed. Talks have gone and there is a player of interest, but they said, look, Fred needs to be sold, or Donny needs to be sold. Now, Fred has an agreement with Galatasaray. Lazio and Fulham are interested in Fred, and obviously Donny's set to go to Real Sociedad, and McTominay could potentially leave. But the reports, if Kobbie Mainoo's injury is bad, they will keep McTominay. Now, Amrabat will move, because I know that Fred will be sold. Fabrizio Romano said that Fred will be sold, but it was said on Amrabat, and Romano said this, that United will push to sign Amrabat after either Fred or Donny van der Beek leaves the club. So we're just waiting on the sale of Fred and Donny. It's Højlund, the sales, Amrabat, and then potentially after Amrabat there could be another signing. If Maguire leaves, it'd be a centre back, potentially someone like Kudus, potentially another attacker. So there could be up to five signings this summer, or six if you include the backup keeper, if we do that. But there's actually a feeling that Kovar could stay and be a backup keeper. James Duckett of the Telegraph said that Manchester United could move for Amrabat towards the end of the window, depending on how successful the club sell over the coming weeks, and that Erik ten Hag ideally would like to make a fourth addition to his squad once Man United have signed a striker. So the goal essentially is Højlund and Rabat get the sales done, and that depends on Fred. Now we're going to talk about the outs, but before we talk about the outs, we've got Maguire bid rejected, we've got Donny going to Real Sociedad, we've got West Ham wanting McTominay and there being a verbal offer there and McTominay wanting the move, we've got Fred agreeing terms, that there's a deal agreed for Fred to go to Galatasaray, Fred's agreed terms to go to Galatasaray, but obviously Galatasaray bidding 8 million for Fred, do one. There was takeover news, and look, the takeover news I feel like is pointless. But people tag me in it, people want me to talk about it. This is the story. Justin, there is expected to be developments on the sale of the club when the team return from the US. Basically, Sky is saying when we return from pre-season, there's going to be developments on the takeover. We were told back in December there will be developments on the takeover in the first quarter of 2023. We were told there'll be developments on the takeover end of March. We were told in April there'll be developments on the takeover by the end of April. We were told in May there'll be developments on the takeover once the season ends. We were told once the season ends there'll be developments on the takeover in June. We were told in June that the deal was imminent by multiple sources. Some sources were even reliable, saying the deal was imminent. You then had the likes of Rio Ferdinand and multiple other sources saying, I'm told there's going to be an announcement tomorrow. And nothing happened. So the fact that Sky and Sky Kavanagh, and I do like Sky Kavanagh, I think he's a good journalist, but the fact that they've come out and said that there's going to be developments on the takeover when we get back from pre-season tour, believe it when I see it. Like, even if Romano said it at this point, and I love Romano, and I just can't believe anything with the takeover till we see it, because how many times have we had sources, good, bad, sources with credible links, Rio Ferdinand, come out and say something's imminent, we're going to find out something soon for it to be denied. I feel like this takeover is going to drag on and on and on. However, we do know that all the kind of paperwork's been done by Ratcliffe and done by Sheikh Yassim, and they've done everything behind the scenes. So if the Glazers do choose, we know it can move quickly because a lot of behind the scenes stuff is done. Could the Glazers be waiting to get Højlund and Amrabat in to announce they're staying? There's a potential. Could it be Sir Jim Ratcliffe because he's not spending any money with Nice? Could it be Qatar because they feel very confident? I don't know. It's so much speculation. I don't know where it's going to go. The Qataris are confident, but Sir Jim Ratcliffe hasn't put out any news that he's not confident. And there's always potential the Glazers would stay, even though it makes no economic sense. But there was a story coming out of Sir Jim Ratcliffe today that I want to cover. And this is exactly why I don't want Sir Jim Ratcliffe. It was said Nice president Jean-Pierre Rivera has confirmed the club's objectives has been revised downwards. Today, the very ambitious project is no longer on the agenda. It isn't linked to the potential purchase of United. Basically, Nice haven't signed anyone, and he said that basically the Nice project has no ambition. Who owns Nice? Ineos. Who's coming out? People that work at Nice are coming out against Ineos. Could that be because they know that Ineos and Sir Jim is likely leaving so they can speak out against him because their jobs are at risk? Is it because just Sir Jim Ratcliffe's a bad owner? Could be a bit of both. The fact that people at Nice are coming out and actually speaking negatively of Sir Jim Ratcliffe, you know, do they think that he's not going to be around much longer and that they can do that? That is particularly worrying. But they're talking about how Sir Jim Ratcliffe's got no ambition at Nice, yet a set number of United fans want Ratcliffe in. Look, I understand not wanting sovereign wealth. I understand not wanting oil money. I understand not wanting Middle Eastern owners and not agreeing with some of the human rights. That I completely understand that. But when we've got an option of Sir Jim, the Glazers or Qatar, Qatar is the best option. It might not be your ideal option, but it is the best option. And I want what's best for United. So Jim isn't good for United. He's got no ambition. The Glazers are the worst case scenario. Qatar, they're not perfect, but look at what Middle Eastern wealth has done to Newcastle, Man City, PSG. It is the way forward. Whether you like it or not, Middle Eastern wealth and football is the way to succeed. And people won't like that. People have agendas. And I just think I want who's going to be the best owner for United. I think the Qatar project's the most exciting. They want to invest in Manchester, the youth team, the women's team, do up the stadium and invest in the squad. And they want to get the deal done now. I want Qatar. But what has been said on the outs? It has been said new Fred agreed personal terms with Galatasaray, but a gap in valuation on a fee still exists. So Fred has officially agreed terms with Galatasaray. Fred wants to go to Galatasaray, but Galatasaray are going to have to put in a proper bid. Fulham and Lazio are also interested in Fred. Saudi Arabia is also interested in Fred. Saudi Arabia is also interested in Eric Bailly. But Alanga has been sold for 15 million. Dean Henderson's likely to go on loan with an obligation to buy. Alex Tellers has been sold for about 5 million. We should get about 5 million for Eric Bailly as well. Fred, we should hopefully get 15 million and Galatasaray can just stop being knobheads. Donny, we should hopefully get 10 million. Potentially, we can get 40 million for Maguire. Potentially, we can get 40 million for McTominay. Potentially, United could be making a lot of money in sales. Now, Unfortunately, the sales we're talking about is players leaving, but the sale we really want is the Glazers leaving the club. I'm sure we're going to get lots of updates in the morning. I'll probably do a video about 11 a.m. UK time, so make sure you subscribe for that. I hope this video was informing. I just wanted to get into lots of news today. I haven't even covered all the news, so there'll definitely be a live stream later. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye.